Hi everyone, good afternoon. This is my author vlog. Still figuring out, trying to figure out a good name for it. Originally was going to call it Creator's Corner, but then I was thinking maybe I should call it More Coffee Please, or something like that. Or maybe Jer's Vile Vlog. I don't know, still figuring it out. But anyway, I'm going to try to do a little short thing every day on the life of a writer. Today's a good day because, last evening, my eldest daughter, she's 24, she joined me to go to the Astronomical Society's stargazing party to watch the Perseid meteor shower up at 11 Mile Reservoir at 11 Mile State Park up in the mountains. At first, I couldn't get anybody to go with me, and which is funny because my youngest son, who's going into college, wants to be an astrophysicist, so you would think he'd want to come, but I couldn't get anybody in my family to go with me, and so we almost didn't go, but my eldest daughter said she would go, and she loves driving, so she did all the driving, blasting her music and all that, and it was an hour and a half away to get up into those mountains at the 11 Mile Reservoir, but we saw a bear. I saw a bear for the first time in Colorado, and I've lived here for like 20 years. This poor young bear was kind of running along the highway by Manitou Springs, sort of heading away from the highway into town. So I was praying after that he got back to nature and didn't go into town. But he had like a mixture of black fur and like golden brown. So he looked like a young one, like a teenager bear or something. And then we also saw several deer, some does with a little fawn with white spots in Woodland Park. And then also, when we were on the small road in the dark, we saw several full-grown stags with full racks of antlers. They were amazing. And I just, thank goodness, none of them jumped into the road. They were standing right next to the road. But anyway, we got there and it was a pretty good sized crowd. Although it was dark, so I couldn't see real well, but everybody was spaced apart. And the guy did a cool talk teaching us about the Milky Way and the constellations and stuff. And we got to see some amazing meteors. I saw the best one I've ever seen in my entire life. It was like a full 3 seconds, a long fiery tail that stretched across half the sky. It was amazing. And it was my daughter's first time to even see a meteor shower. And she's the best one I've seen in my entire life. So anyway, it was really fun. It was cold and she got too cold, so we had to leave early. It ran from 9 to 11 p.m. But what does this have to do with writing? Well, two things. Well, one is that recently I was writing about my characters in my ghostwriting. They were out in the middle of the Sahara Desert, so they saw this full sky of stars. So it was kind of fun to kind of see something a little bit like what they might have seen. And then also, I just got commissioned to write a children's book about space and the solar system. So that was really fun. But the more important thing is, I was struggling with the ending of writing book 3 for my client. It's a YA urban fantasy novel series. And I was struggling with the ending. And I kept trying to brainstorm ideas at home and I wasn't satisfied with where it was going. And so I took advantage of the hour and a half drive up and the hour and a half drive back to really just think through it and brainstorm. And some really interesting ideas came. You know, getting ideas while going on long drives is very effective. And so today I was able to crank out this new ending I kind of had come up with, and I like it much better. And I actually finished this first draft of book 3. So my goal is to submit it by Sunday. So I have the next 3 days to go through and revise and edit and all that sort of thing. And of course, this is ghostwriting, so my client can then take it and do with it what she wants. She can change it or edit it or revise it. I don't think she's doing much of that, but she can if she wants. So that was really good. Got book 3 finished. If I can get it completely revised and submitted by Sunday, then I'll have all next week to focus on that children's book, which I'm hoping will just take me a couple of hours. But we'll see. My brain's already worrying with ideas for it. So, just like any artist, or lawyer for that matter, when you have projects you're working on, it's like you never stop thinking about it. You spend time going over ideas and thinking through stuff. And you're not getting paid for that time. You're just during your, while you're doing other activities, you're thinking and thinking and thinking and coming up with ideas. So it's part of the life of a writer.